Very good evening to you. Thank you for joining us. Welcome to Sports Tonight. This is the Tuesday night edition of the show. Promises to be exciting, fun-filled, with a lot to share with you tonight. My name is Tony Bitoy. I want to start off the show by saying a very big thank you to you for joining us. And also promise you that if you stay with us for the next 50 minutes, that we'll be bringing Sports Tonight to you. We will make sure it is worth your while. We'll make sure you enjoy every bit of it. And what we'll be doing on the program tonight, of course, will include taking you across the globe. We'll take you to Rio, venue of the 2016 Olympic Games. We will also be taking you across some of the major sports in Europe, because as we speak, games are going on in the UEFA Champions League. We'll talk about that on the program tonight. We will also, on Sports Tonight this Tuesday, fill you in with a good share of domestic football. Tomorrow, action resumes in the Nigeria Professional Football League. We'll give you all the lowdown. Today, in Lokoja, the Kogi State capital, it was good for Tornadoes of Minna against Akwa United. We'll fill you in with all of those stories. We will also, on the program tonight, be talking Nigeria National League. We'll give you what it looks like, the standings across the different groups, and the results of games played over the weekend. So you are in for a very, very loaded package. And I just want to ask you to stay with us and enjoy every bit of what we have on offer for you this Tuesday. All right, so let's roll together. Let me start by telling you how you can be part of the show by means of feedback. For those of you who watch us all the time, you are very familiar with the way you can be a part of the show through feedback. But in case you are watching us for the very first time and you are wondering how you can connect with us, how you can engage with us, how you can interact with us on Sports Tonight, what you see right there on your screen provides you the guide to being able to interact with us on the program tonight. So we expect you to give us your thoughts, your opinion, your reaction, your ideas, what you feel could be your contributions to the issues that we raise and talk about on the program tonight. I've already given you an outline. You can take advantage of those platforms on your screen for Facebook, Twitter, to talk to us and to interact with us. All right, so please take advantage of it, and we will be reading out your comments, your thoughts, and we will need a lot of it as we go along on Sports Tonight this Tuesday. Let's also tell you very quickly that you can watch us on our website, www.channelstv.com, and of course on youtube.com/channelsweb. If you click on m.channelstv.com, it allows you to watch us on your BlackBerry, your iPhone, or your iPad. Connects you straight to your home for the news. And if you go a step further, which is to download the channels app for Android, iOS, or Windows from their respective stores, it keeps you exactly where we want you to be. That's the best place for you to be. Channels is at your fingertips. You are able to track every single thing on Channels TV 24/7, and that's the perfect place for you. And of course, as you do that on the program tonight and follow all the guidelines that we've given you for feedback, tell us where your comments are coming from, your posts, your tweets. We will appreciate you for it on Sports Tonight this very beautiful Tuesday. All right? Before I go on and talk about Team Nigeria and, of course, the Olympic Games and introduce, of course, my guests that will be with me all through the show, let us start the show off tonight on a rather sober note. And, of course, you know, anytime we go this way, it means probably we've lost a very important person. And, of course, indeed we have. And this time we're talking about former president of the World Soccer Governing Body, FIFA, Yao Avalanche. We lost him at the very ripe age of 100. Avalanche was the predecessor to Sepp Blatter at FIFA. He served FIFA from 1974 to 1998. That's 24 years of service to football. He resigned as FIFA's honorary president in April 2013 following an investigation into bribery allegations and was admitted to hospital the following year with a lung infection. Avalanche led the World Cup's expansion from 16 to 32 teams with 6 competitions held under his tenure. And he holds the record of being the man who broke all the barriers. Well, a lot of positives for me, a lot more positives to report about him than negatives. He broke the barrier and made the World Cup truly global, made it really a World Cup, expanding it from 16 teams to 32 teams. Of course, controversies left and right, but then this man had a lot more positives to what he was able to do for football, particularly for Africa, than negatives. All right? So he's passed on now at a very ripe age of 100, and we can only wish him eternal rest. May his soul rest in perfect peace. That's the story of Yao Avalanche, the Brazilian who has passed on. All right, thank you for staying with us. It's time for us now to quickly start up the show. This time, of course, we're talking about Rio 2016 update. And we'll be giving you a lowdown on all that's going down. Hopefully, we should also be able to take you right there to Action Sports in Rio. We'll try to connect with Austin Okonapan, and then we'll be able to give you on-the-spot reports. But let me just quickly introduce to you my partners. They will be with me all through the rest of the show. Cosmos Chukwuemeka is here. It's a Tuesday. We're happy to have him. Cosmos, good to have you on Sports Tonight.
Yeah, good evening, Tony.
And of course, Yemi Adebayo is also on the show. Yemi, good to have you on Sports Tonight.
Always a pleasure.
Yeah. Before I give you the Team Nigeria update, let me just quickly tell you that the women's football event semi-final games are going on. The semi-final game is already concluded. The host, Brazil, have lost out. They lost 3-4 on penalties to Sweden. And I have this feeling that the hosts will not win the football event for men, and they will not win for women. Obviously, they're not going to win for the women. I also have the feeling they're not going to win for the men. They may get to the final, but I keep my...
I have a feeling that Sweden are destined for big things.
Women's game.
They've defeated all the teams that you would expect to win this tournament.
U.S.
go
on penalties.
A lot of people were angry with them, with the way they dispatched the United States. They said it was anti-football.
Negative, packing the bus. But women can also pack the bus.
Yes, but the coach said they are on their way home, and we are still here.
And that's the same thing with Brazil.
That's what has happened with Brazil. So I have a feeling they're destined for greatness.
Yeah, I mean, if you take out U.S. and you take out the Brazilians, in front of their fans, then you fancy your chances of winning.
Exactly. Right?
And the second semifinal is going on. Germany are 1-0 up over Canada, all right, in the second semifinal currently going on. The game is in the second half. So it's possible we have all European final, Sweden against Germany, if the results stay the way they are. All right, that's for the women football event. Let's just start off now quickly, talk about Team Nigeria. Our focus, of course, is on Team Nigeria. Yesterday, we didn't have too many positives to report. It was not a good day for Team Nigeria. But today looks fairly better for us as Team Nigeria. So we are starting off the show tonight by talking about Team Nigeria. Let's see very quickly if that is going to come on your screen, the summary of Team Nigeria today at the Olympic Games. And hopefully, before, at the end of that, we should be able to speak with Austin Okonapan, who is in Rio, to give us a lowdown. Yemi, Team Nigeria, let's take a look at the issues quickly, one after the other. The first one has got to be, let's talk boxing first of all. Ife Ajagba, all right, that's it on your screen, is battling Kazakhstan's Ivan Dikko for a place in the men's 91 kg boxing event. Semifinals, later today, he has a chance to move into the medal zone. If he wins this one, then bronze is guaranteed for Ife Ajagba. That should fire him up.
But his opponent is a bronze medalist from the last Olympics, London 25. And guess who he lost to? His opponent actually lost to Anthony Joshua right there.
Yeah.
Just show how far this guy
has gone how difficult this is for Ife Ajagba. We're going to talk about it, but let me just run through the stories. Divine Oduduru, today qualified for the semifinals of the 200 meters event. He ran his personal best, 20.34 seconds. Finished second behind the greatest athletes of all time, Usain Bolt, who won heat 9 in 20.28 seconds. Well, Bolt literally jogged through the 200
the last
meters.
50 meters.
He just
and
strolled
he had time
to
take pictures.
He just strolled through.
Yeah.
Well, in a few minutes or hours from now, Blessing Okagbare, who is in the semifinals of the women's 200 meters, will be racing. We are hoping for Blessing not just to qualify for the finals and do better than she did in the 100 meters. We are also hoping that she gets a podium finish. Yeah. Tough, but not impossible. Mm. 400 meters hurdles for women. Good one for us. Olua Tobiloba Amuson qualified. Feed best time for the semifinals. Not very good, but then she's through to the semis all the same. But
that's all that matters.
Mm. That's all that matters, and we see if she can improve and probably get a place in the finals. And of course, the big one everybody's been talking about is the football tomorrow. Dream Team 6, Olympic Eagles, are up against Germany. About this time tomorrow, we should have scored a few goals and be up and running for a place in the football event final for the men. All right, so those are the stories from Team Nigeria. Mm. Very quickly, guys, let me get your thoughts while we wait to see if we can hook up with Austin Okonakwan. Yemi, you were talking about Ife Ajagba. Knockout in his first game, in his first bout, but you don't go into the Olympic Games, an amateur event, hoping that you score a knockout. The rounds are just about three or four rounds. Mm. You score points.
The like you said, there's a problem with African boxers, Nigerian boxers.
They have the power.
They're always looking for the knockout, and you know, other people start counting points, and before it's over, before it began, he's fighting a tough opponent. We say, but this is his biggest test. The last one, even before people sat down, 2.45 seconds. A lot of people were sitting on ticket issues, and it was all over. Medal prospect. If he wins this, I have a feeling we're not going to go back empty-handed. I'm looking at her. I'm looking at football. There are probably a couple from
athletics,
maybe not even athletics, from the wrestlers. You know, so I'm thinking
wrestling is starting tomorrow as well.
Yeah,
I'm thinking it's not going to be all gloom and doom.
I
feel the good news will start from later tonight. Boxing, we take it there from Blessing. She gets something. Who knows?
Football.
Amusha as well.
Things could just turn around for us.
Today might just be the turning point for us.
The minister says we are not coming back empty-handed. Maybe he has seen what Yemi is seeing now.
For once,
that's why he's so confident that something will happen for us.
Well, the athletes are really showing that despite all the shenanigans before the Olympic, that they could actually dig deep by getting something. So, so based on that, based on the belief of the athletes and the Nigerian spirit in them, yes, I will believe that. Not what the minister is saying, because, I mean, look at how the preparation is. He talks about Efe. I'm talking about a certain Divine Odudu. I mean, in his personal best of 20.34 seconds, it was awesome the way he ran. He actually said before then that he doesn't care if Usain Bolt was there or not, he ran. Mm. And of course, in the semifinals too, he's going to be running in heat 7 with Usain Bolt too.
All right.